That's right, Joe. Well, Tulsi is back there waiting, but welcome to you, Senator. Thank you very much for joining us.
It's another exciting primary night. What can I say?
We seem to do this every few years.
I know.
We also always appreciate you coming back.
Of course.
You know, we spoke to Senator Schatz about some local issues, rail among them, and the mayors and what their choice is. For you, you know, I think something interesting to talk to you about, maybe more on a national level, and looking ahead to our presidential election. I say that because I know earlier this week, you actually had the privilege of swearing in.
Oh, yes, so 77 new U.S. citizens. So that's a very meaningful thing for me as an immigrant myself. And, you know, it just pointed out once again that there were dozens of countries represented. The youngest was 18, the oldest was like 76 or so, and the diversity that that is our country. And this is why, as a country of immigrants, yes, the original peoples were here before the rest of us, but for one candidate to be bashing immigrants, the latest being the Filipinos, is just outrageous.
And that leads me to my question. Born and raised, or born in Japan, the first Asian-born U.S. senator down the road. When you hear some of the vitriol coming out of this campaign, and obviously you alluded to Mr. Trump and some of the comments that he has made, what does this do to the USA's standing internationally when people listen to this type of dialogue?
I think that the world looks at our country as a democracy where we welcome people to come and you know, with their desire to make a better life for themselves and the contributions that they make. So I think they look at our country as really the country of hope. And for one of the candidates to continue to say things such as Muslims are not welcome, criticizing Mexicans, Filipinos, that is not the country that they thought of America, and certainly not the country that I think of as America. That's why this election is so momentous. We need to elect somebody who has the kind of experience and understanding, and including, by the way, how we need to work with our allies all across the world.
Makes sense. Yes. Bringing it back home, let's talk about some issues local that are near and dear to your heart. And I know you were over on a neighbor island this past week talking about the STEM program, science, technology, engineering, and math. Education is something very big for you, and especially to see the young people engaging in these skills.
Yes.
We need to have our future mathematicians and scientists and engineers.
Well, for Hawaii to diversify our economy, because yes, we're very grateful for the strength of our tourism industry and the military spending, and I do my very best in the Armed Services Committee to make sure that Hawaii remains very strong and a critical part of national defense in the rebalance to the Asia Pacific. At the same time, there is recognition all along the spectrum that we need people with STEM education and backgrounds. And in the state of Hawaii alone, I'm told that in 2 years we'll need about 17,000 people with this kind of background for the jobs that will become available. So about a week or so ago, I did a field hearing on focusing on women and minorities in STEM, because they are dropping out, especially women, at all levels of the STEM pipeline. And if we don't take advantage of the talents of this huge group of people, we will be missing the boat, and we will be not utilizing the talents of half our population.
Part of the key to that is providing an opportunity for affordable education.
Oh, definitely.
And that goes right into another one of, I know, your pet projects.
Something I know about, because I put myself through college through a work-study program, and I took out loans to go to law school. It took me 15 years to pay off those loans. But college expenses are even greater now. When I talk to kids as young as in fifth grade who come to visit me in D.C., they say, you know, their parents are worried about college affordability. So the plan to make college affordable, include that the Democrats in the Senate are pushing, has one of my ideas, which is to make Pell Grants the biggest grant program that enables students to go to college. I would say a huge percentage of the students attending Manoa and our community colleges rely on Pell Grants, so I have a provision in the bill that the Senate Democrats are pushing for that makes Pell Grants that much stronger. But we have to do this because I see this as a huge opportunity gap. We're going to see fewer people being able to afford to go to college, and when we talk about STEM, a lot of that is, you know, higher education, and we need to support that.
And higher education could also be community colleges. And in
of
fact,
course. No, it is very much a part
Hawaii
of it.
Hawaii actually got a sometimes dubious distinctions being number one, but this time a great distinction. We were number one in a national poll that I know we reported on this week of having affordable community colleges
yes.
here. And the University of Hawaii system has some great community
yes.
colleges.
And in fact, the community colleges are very flexible in responding to the needs, workforce needs of our business community. And I happen to know that they do that really well. But as I said, I was at the University of Hawaii just this week focusing on innovation and entrepreneurship in our state. So there were people who were small businesses who came together to talk about how can they get patents, for example. How can they ensure that as small businesses they'll be able to succeed? How can we sponsor and support entrepreneurship and innovation, because that's how Hawaii is going to remain competitive in the global economy. It's through our creativity and our willingness to take risks and being entrepreneurs. So I hosted these two sessions at the University of Hawaii just 2 days ago.
Engage them, educate them, and then the third step, keep them here.
Oh, definitely, yes.
Yeah.
And in fact, when we grow our own STEM workforce, that's a more stable workforce. And I also serve on the Intelligence Committee, and we have a huge intelligence presence in Hawaii with the NSA, and I have been working with them, and they have been outreaching because they are going to need thousands of people with computer backgrounds and those kinds of STEM skills in order to fill our needs. And I'm sure everybody knows that cybersecurity is a huge concern
yes.
for all of us.
The Democratic Party knows that very well right now as we speak.
Yes. Not just the party, but all of us.
Absolutely.
Probably your station needs to worry about that.
Oh, too. We all need to worry. I got my cell phone right here. I have two daughters. Believe me, I
very
worry about
good.
It. Senator Mazie Hirono,
thank you
very much. Best of luck to you. We look forward to seeing you again.
And I want this is the primary election night. I want to wish all of our candidates the very best because, everyone works hard and puts their best foot forward to garner the support of our community, and I've been there many times.
And those of us not in politics and who would never dare venture into those waters, much respect
it's
for anybody who dares.
It's not everybody's cup of tea.
It is not indeed. So thank you very much for your service.
Thank you. Right. It's a privilege.
Thank
Aloha.
You. Aloha. Joe, back to you.